In this video, we're going to take a look at how to use a client script to get the current record ID of the module that you're working in, and to then use that ID to be able to grab some information and update related records with it. And so let's get started. From the home page, we'd come in and we will go to client script. And I'm going to go ahead and use ones that I've already created to make it go a little quicker. This would be, so when you're creating the new client script, of course, you give it the name, the categories module. We're doing on the edit page of deals. This happens to have a layout ID. The event type, we're looking at a field. So when we change, in this case, the site city, then we want to be able to grab that information and update the related quotes or estimates for that record. So, of course, we start off with building a variable, and then we're going to get the field. The API name is shipping city, and we want the value for it. And here's the important one. This is how we get the actual record ID of the current record that we will be in. And so it's a page function. And from that, then we can get kind of just like in a deluge function, we want related records. So our variable name, we're just going to call it related records. And it's ZDK apps, CRM, and we're going from the deals module. And we want fetch related records. We're going to use that record ID. And then the API name is quotes for the related list. And then here is our loop. We want to be able to go through that. So we're going to start our variable. We're going to just use I. We start at zero because remember in our lists, anytime we grab a list, we have different indexes and the starting index is always zero. And so we're going to check to see if zero is less than the length of how many we received. And then we're going to add to our variable when it's gone through. So we are going to get the related records, the first instance, and we're going to set the deal city to city, which is what we grabbed up here. And then we are actually going to update that related record using the index, the record ID, and estimates, because that is what the module looks like, is called. And notice it's different from the API name in this case. And so we went ahead and used it. And then we had the record, related records, the index. And then here, that's given us the ID of that related record. And so very simple. The key things to know is getting the record ID from the page and then being able to grab the related records, knowing the related list name versus the API name. And so fairly simple, fairly easy. Here again, then you can run and test out your results on this. And this would be if we were changing the field site city. So here, we'll go ahead and run this. And if I was to come down here and change, then it would run and it would update those related records. And so That is how we do it. It's fairly simple. Key parts again are getting the record ID and getting the related records and setting up your loop to go through them. So the cool thing is this works for even if there's just one related record, it will work. Or if there were none, because sometimes you may not have the deal already quoted, it's not going to do this at all. So, and we'll still give you a nice clean run. And that is how you work with related records and getting the record ID. Thank you and have a good day.
If you found this video helpful, be sure to like it and leave us a comment. You can also subscribe to our channel and click the bell next to the subscribe button to be notified of new videos. If you want to learn more about Zoho or would like help with anything Zoho related, head on over to our website at zcrmhelp.com to connect with us. Thanks for watching.